our lessons a long time ago. Long time at the moment. However, so today we are going to do this part 7.1, kinetic energy. So, in most instances, we see moving things. Wind, a moving vehicle, flowing water and a moving pebble can be given as examples. So that means they say that it's a true thing. That means in here also when I'm talking, my hands moving, hands get moves and my mouth get moves like that. However, it goes like that and only non-living objects do not show moving things if they didn't get any energy. So however, let us find out whether the moving objects have some sort of energy. So let's find out it. So you will need a turbine made by fixing metal blades to a cork stopper, a metal rod, a ball, a moving car, and a piece of stone and a bowl of water. So if we get the turbine, you can hold the turbine under the water tap, so it sends water now. So then you will observe that it get rotate. So the next one, keep the ball on a table and send the toy car towards it. So in there, when the toy car hit on the ball, the ball also trying to get, that is not trying, ball also get moved to another place and drop the piece of stone into still water. So the, you know, a bowl of water, so the ball, you have to put a stone to that bowl, but remember that bowl have to be full with water. So when you place that, I think you will observe that water rays are going to the, if you say that, by radiuses, it is like circles, it goes until it ends. So you may have observed that some work is done in each of the above activities. Can you say from where the energy was obtained for the work done? Yes. If we get the first one, the toy car get moved by a wind spring, or it can be a chemical cell, so some kind of a battery or cell. So in the stone, when the stone get the water move, that means water's circles get built because of the stone. So stone's moving power, the ball moves because of the car's moving power, and the turbine rotate because of the power of water, the moving of water. So the energy for above work is gained from the moving object. So I told you that. So examples, flowing water, moving stone, so like that it goes. This activity reveals us that moving objects have energy. Yes, if they haven't any energy, how do they move? Yes, non-living things haven't energy, so they don't move. But not planets like that. Okay, so this sector releases, okay, energy that a moving object contains is called kinetic energy. So this is a new word that you have to learn, kinetic energy. So I told you about these ones in the last one. At the end I explain a little bit. So you have to remember this, kinetic energy, energy that a moving object contains. So when object is moving, it contains kinetic energy. Okay, so electricity can be generated by kinetic energy of sea waves, grinding grains, pumping water, and generating electricity can be done using kinetic energy of wind. So electricity is generated in a hydropower station using kinetic energy of water. So if we get most instances, kinetic energy is the thing that we use to produce electricity, because the dynamo wants to get dynamo wants to get rotated to produce electricity. So some power is used, like water. However, that they also use moving water. So in this grind mill, so in here you can see that there are four wings like things. So they rotate and the grains get grind. So today our lesson is over. So you have to do an assignment about list out 5 objects which contain kinetic energy. I will make it 10 objects. Okay, so it's easy. And so see ya.